Hello, future engineers. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If you're still new to my channel and you like what I'm doing, please don't forget to share my videos to your friends and to your friends' friends. That's one way you can keep me going, inspired and refreshed. Now, if you find my videos interesting and important to your studies, also please don't forget to subscribe. So here is Vitamath 12. Three circles are externally tangent to each other. The sums of any two radii are 16 cm, 19 cm, and 21 cm. Determine the area bounded by the three circles. So to help visualize the situation, so let's have the three circles. So we will denote the radius of the smallest circle as R1, the next R2, and the largest circle in this problem as R3. So therefore, the 16 cm here, common sense, should be the sum of the smallest and the next smaller circle. So that is R1 plus R2 equals 16, and this is the area bounded by the three circles. Call that area A, and to solve that area we need to connect the centers of the three circles so that this area is equal to the area of the triangle minus area of this sector, area minus area of this sector and minus the area of this largest sector in this problem, where the area of the sector is 1/2 radius squared times central angle in radians, and the area of the triangle is 1/2 product of adjacent sides times sine of included angle. And I select this angle to be the angle to be used because this is the largest angle opposite the longest side. So to determine the sides, we need to solve for R1, R2, and R3. As I said, R1 plus R2 should be equal to 16, equation 1. Then R1 plus R3, so the smallest and the largest sum should be 19. So R1 plus R3 equals 19, and the sum of these larger circles should be sum of the larger radii of radius of the larger circle should be 21. That is R2 plus R3 equals 21. So if we subtract equation 1 from equation 2, we can eliminate R1 and establish another equation. So equation 1 is subtracted from equation 2, that is R3 minus R2, eliminated R1 equals 19 minus 16, so 3. R3 minus R2 equals 3. Then we process equations 2 and equation 2-1 by adding them to eliminate R2, so we can solve R3. So adding 2R3 equals 21 plus 3 is 24. So R3 is 12 cm. Substitute into equation 2, R2 plus 12 equals 21. So R2 is 21 minus 12, 9 cm. R2 is 9 cm. Then in equation 1, R2 is 9. So R1 plus 9 equals 16. So R1 is 16 minus 9. R1 is 7 cm. Then in this triangle, applying cosine law, so R1 plus R3, so let's put the radii so that we can analyze the sides of the triangle. So this is the, this is the longest side, 21. So therefore, I'll compute for theta 1. So call this theta 2, this one theta 3. So let's solve for theta 1 by cosine law. Remember cosine law, opposite side square of the opposite side equals the sum of the squares of the other sides minus twice the product of the other sides times cosine of the angle between those two sides. So that is 21, area by the way is area of triangle minus area of sector 1 minus area of sector 2 minus area of sector 3. And we can only find the area of the sector if we know the central angles. So 21 square equals 16 square plus 19 square minus 2 times 16 times 19 cosine of theta 1. So using your calculator, we can solve theta 1 equals 73.17 degrees. Then since this is the largest angle and it is still acute, so we are safe so using the law of science is safe in this problem. Remember that the law of science is not an absolute equation, because there is an ambiguous case when one of the angles is greater than 90 degrees or obtuse, so it will fail if you rely on your calculator. So it is cosine law that is the absolute law, and there's no confusion with the use of law of cosines. But because this biggest angle is theta 1 and it is still acute, then as I said, it is safe to apply the law of sines in this triangle to solve for theta 2 and theta 3, and we will do that. So that is 19, so times pi over 180 degrees to convert that to radians. So theta 1 is 1.277 radians. So by sine law, 19 as to sine of theta 2 equals 16 as to sine of theta 3 equals 21 as to sine of theta 1, which is 73.17 degrees. So we can now solve for theta 2. Theta 2 is equal to 60 degrees or pi over 3 radians. Theta 3 is 16 sine 73.17 over 21 inverse sine, so 46.83 degrees times pi over 180 degrees to convert that to radians is equal to 0.8173 radians. We then substitute into the formula, and remember the area of triangle is 1/2 product of adjacent sides, which are 16 and 19 times sine of theta 1. So 1/2 of 16 times 19 sine of theta 1, that's the area of this triangle here, blue bounded blue triangle, then minus area of sector 1, which is 1/2 radius square, 1/2 7 square, times theta 1 in radians, which is 1.277. So 1/2 7 square times 1.277 minus this sector here, 1/2 of 9 square minus 1/2 of 9 square times theta 2, which is pi over 3 radians. Then minus this sector here, which is 1/2 12 square theta 3, which is 0.8173. So we can now solve for that area required. The first term is 145.49. The second is minus 31.286. Then minus 42.412. Then minus 58.846. The area, therefore, is equal to 12.95 square centimeters. Now for your part, so that you will also learn from here, from my channel, then this is your problem. Three externally tangent identical circles are internally tangent to an equilateral triangle. If the area bounded between these three circles is 64.5 square units, determine the area of the equilateral triangle. So these three are identical, then there is an equilateral triangle circumscribing them. The area between the circles is given 64.5 square units. To find the area of the triangle circumscribing them, but this time they are identical. So that's it. That's for your part. And the answer is, I want you to get this answer, 5171 square units.